Hi, I'm Dr. Sridhar Kalyanasundaram, consultant neonatologist and pediatrician. Welcome to my channel. Thank you for subscribing and turning on the notifications as we requested earlier. We had a video on fever and its management, and in this video we will shortly look at infections. When we say infection, it's basically an organism which is bacteria, a fungus or virus which has entered into our body. Sometimes organisms coexist with us. These are called colonizers, and the gut microbiota, we will discuss that separately when we talk of probiotics. So the gut microbiota also are colonizers in the body, and there is a mutual coexistence where you may have functions which are beneficial to the host as well as there are functions which are beneficial to the bacteria which is colonizing the gut. So this is one aspect where colonizers are there. Sometimes there may be changes in the host, like breakdown in the skin barrier, where the bacteria can enter from the surface into the body bloodstream. And if you have conditions like immune compromise, there may be serious infections. So infection is when the organism becomes more virulent, it has managed to get a grip on the host, it is multiplying in the host and causing problems. So the difference between a colonization and infection is that the bacteria is peacefully coexisting in terms of colonizers, and the same organism, if it becomes more virulent, it causes problems in the body, it's an infection. Infection doesn't by itself mean it's a life-threatening or a serious condition. So we may have different manifestations of the infection depending on which area of the body is affected. And the severity depends on both the infection factors. If the bacteria is very virulent or the virus is very virulent, it can cause a serious problem. If it is a mild infection, it can just manifest like a skin rash, or a baby may have a mild sore throat or a cold, and then it will resolve on its own. The body fights it off. So these are milder infections. The manifestations of an infection depends on the host response as well as the bug's own reaction in the body. So for example, if you have a bacteria which produces a chemical called endotoxin, this may circulate in the bloodstream. It may cause chills, it may cause shock, which means the blood pressure is dropping and it may be serious and life-threatening. Some of the chemicals released by the infection may cause diarrhea and vomiting. These are called toxins. And in the case of bacteria called tetanus, the toxin that is produced causes very severe spasm of the muscles and seizures. The body fighting the infection produces manifestations like chills. You may have fever, which is due to the resetting of the thermostat. And then we have the manifestations that we attribute to the infection, like the sneezing, the runny nose, the watering eyes, the sticky eyes and so on, which are actually produced by the body's own cells which are fighting the infection. So these are side effects of the body's response to the infection that we are manifesting. So it's very important to see that the organisms which produce infection can be of different types. So bacteria are microscopic organisms. These are cellular and they can reproduce on their own. They are the commonest reason of serious infections, and it's important to remember that the bacterial infections are the ones that need antibiotics. The viral infections are much more common than bacterial infections. Of course, we are very worried about the term virus once the coronavirus came into the picture, and it has caused a huge problem all over the world. But there are multiple viruses which cause just a minor upset of the body's mechanisms for a couple of days, and then the body fights it off and the virus vanishes. The difference between the bacteria and the virus is that the virus is not an independent organism. Some people dispute if it is living at all, because it cannot live on its own. The virus has the chemical material, the genetic material that can trigger protein production in the body. It modifies the body function and it can multiply in the cells, but using the cell's own, our body's own mechanisms to produce RNA and DNA and so on. So there are different types of viruses depending on what chemical nature they have. The fungi are the molds. So these are part of the environment as well. And sometimes when we have irritation of the skin, for example, you may have a fungal infection. We have fungus in our oral cavity, so babies may have a oral thrush, which is a fungal infection called candidiasis. Sometimes the fungus that is there in the oral cavity comes through, and if there is a erosion in the nappy area, they cause an infection called candidal or nappy rash. So this will need specific treatment for the fungal infection. So most of the fungal infections are innocuous infections of the mouth, the anal area, or it can be on the skin anywhere in the body. It's called a ringworm or tinea. Fungal infections are life-threatening only in the immunocompromised host usually, and in the terms of neonatology, we have the premature babies who are immunocompromised, and the serious fungal infections may sometimes be seen in them. In the following videos, we will be looking at some of the specific areas which are affected, so we will go through them in sequence. To finish this video, I would like to stress that the nature of the infection, the virulence of the organism, these are the main factors that determine how the body responds and how life-threatening or serious the condition is. One important factor to remember is that majority of the infections are viral, which do not need antibiotics. So remember that antibiotics are not needed for majority of the infections. Don't insist on taking antibiotics. If the pediatrician advises you to monitor the infection, please do so. Don't insist on starting antibiotics. Unnecessary use of antibiotics may have side effects, which we will discuss in a separate video on antibiotic treatment. I hope this video helps. I request you to subscribe if you have not already done so. Do turn on notifications so that you get the information when new videos are uploaded. And do share with your friends who would also benefit from this. Thank you.